Lisa here. Today I'm going to share with you a few cards that I have made, and I must really want spring to come because these cards I'm showing all have flowers on it. And if you looked outside my window, we still have 6-7 foot snowbanks outside, so we are not going to be seeing any flowers for a while. So the first card I'm going to share with you, I can't remember where I got this stamp from, not that it matters, but it was on our travels, and I love this stamp, it's so pretty. And then I colored the image up with my Copics, and then I stamped again, and I colored the butterflies, and then I fussy cut the butterflies out. So as you can see, there are two layers of these butterflies. And then I even shaded them all. But the thing I did was I added some sparkle, which I thought was going to be pretty. I used this, and I was hoping it was an iridescent, but now that I put it on, it's more of a silver, and I don't like the silver on there. You can't see the shading as much, in my opinion anyway. I can't see my shading as much with the Copics. So that is my first card, and then we'll open the inside up. And as you know, I usually use the recipe card or index card on the inside, but I found these paper notepads, and I think they were from Michael's, if I'm not mistaken. And what I like about them is I like that they're the brown, because usually I end up inking them, like inking the whole recipe card in the Distress ink. But you know what? I really like how these ones come like that, so I'll be using those quite a bit. So that's my first card. And then my second card is this one here with the blossom stamp. And I have used this stamp before. And what I did was I wanted to play with my Tim Holtz Distress markers. So that's what I was doing on this one. And this image here, let me see, do I have it here? Yes. This image, it's this stamp here. But when you stamp it, all the blossoms, the inside of the blossoms and the inside of the branch are blank. So you can color the inside. So what I first did was I took my markers and I colored on the actual stamp, I colored in the branch and with the green or a brown, I can't remember now, I think it's a green, and then I colored in the blossom, so when you stamp it, it was blank inside, so you just had the colors of them. So then I took my Distress markers and I colored the inside of the blossom and then also the inside of the branch. And with the blossom, I used a couple different colors to get the shading in there. But yeah, I wanted to play around with my Distress markers. And I still haven't watercolored with them yet, so we'll see how that goes. And then another thing I did was I just punched out three of these little flowers from the punch and then formed them into my hand and then added some little rhinestones on there. And then here is the inside. And again, I was playing with the Tim Holtz Distress markers. And this stamp, this is a really neat stamp because it is, this part here is blank. So you can put whatever word you want on there. So I stamped in smile. And then if you look closely, again with the Distress markers, I did that ombre effect with the lighter shade going to the darker shade. So that is my second card. And then my third card, another blossom, and I love that they are the exact same stamp, but the way I colored them and used them, they're totally different. But the reason I made this card is my girlfriend came over, and she had this stamp here. It's the butterfly and then the square, surrounded by the square. And I'm like, oh, I like that stamp. I got to use it. So I stamped it a few times, and then I came up with the idea of, first, I stamped it on just this burgundy color paper, or this purple color paper, and then I stamped it on some pattern paper and fussy cut out the butterfly, and then just again adhered the body. So you can see the stamp underneath, and then this is pattern. These are three different pattern papers, but it's really hard to tell now that they're so close together. It looks like the same pattern paper. And then I think I might have used my Copics on this one. I'm not sure which one I colored that one in. And then I used the brown notepad paper for in there, so I like that too. And then this one here, I don't like to waste. I don't like to throw away things that don't work. So when I stamped the butterflies on the front, this one here, it didn't stamp very well in the middle. But when you put it on here, you can't really tell. So I kept it and I added it as a little embellishment for the inside of the card. So those are my latest cards to share with you. And as you can see, I want spring to come so badly. I can't wait to get rid of this white, dirty snow and get some greenery and some flowers growing out. So thank you everybody for watching and joining me today. And I hope you had a very creative day today. Bye now.
Time doesn't hesitate, and our hands won't slow.